Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Encountering Chinese Channel Festival Edition. Today is a traditional Chinese festival, the Zhongyuan Festival. The Zhongyuan Festival is an ancient festival passed down from ancient times, with an extremely long history. It's more akin to Halloween or the Day of the Dead, so the Zhongyuan Festival is also known as the Oriental Ghost Festival. And what we're going to talk about today is the legends, folk customs, and taboos related to the Zhongyuan Festival. The legend of the Zhongyuan Festival originates from a Buddhist story. According to the legend, before the venerable monk Modgalyana became a monk, he was a well-known filial son. His mother was very careless and often dropped food on the ground while cooking or eating. To protect his mother's self-esteem, after she left, Modgalyana would pick up the fallen food from the ground, wash it with water, and then eat it. Later, Modgalyana's parents passed away, and he chose to become a monk. As a monk, he diligently studied Buddhist teachings and eventually became the Buddha's most accomplished disciple in supernatural powers. After attaining these powers, Modgalyana's first thought was to help liberate his deceased parents' spirits as a way to repay their kindness in raising him. Knowing that his mother's spirit wouldn't be in the heavens due to her wastefulness with food, Modgalyana used his divine vision to search the 8 great hells for her. He searched through various hells, including a crying hell, great crying hell, fiery hell, and a freezing hell, but couldn't find his mother's spirit among the suffering souls. Modgalyana didn't give up and continued his search. Finally, he arrived at the most terrifying hell, Avicii Hell, located at the deepest part of hell. This hell housed sinners who committed unforgivable and heinous crimes in the human realm. There, among a group of emaciated and hungry ghosts, he found a figure resembling his mother. Upon closer inspection, he confirmed it was indeed her. His mother's appearance was pitiable, with long dirty hair, a pale and emaciated face, and a body reduced to skin and bones. She could barely sit up. Modgalyana rushed to her side, and upon seeing him, his mother burst into tears. Regretting her past sins, she pleaded for his help to escape the hell. Feeling immense compassion for his mother, Modgalyana used his magical powers to conjure a bowl of delicious food and placed it before her. As she eagerly reached for the food, it transformed into burning charcoal, scorching her hands and causing her pain. Every attempt to eat resulted in the same outcome, charcoal turning into food when it hit the ground. Witnessing his mother's suffering, Modgalyana realized that his powers could not outweigh her accumulated sins. He had to leave Avicii Hell. He returned to the monastery seeking guidance from his teacher, requesting help to rescue his mother from becoming a hungry ghost. His teacher inquired, "Do you know what sins your mother committed while she was alive?" Modgalyana replied, "Yes, she was greedy, wasteful, and selfish in her actions, which included wasting food." His teacher explained that her sins were too severe and required the collective merit of many to redeem her. "How can I gather so much merit from others to save my mother?" Modgalyana asked. His teacher replied, "On the 15th day of the 7th lunar month, the monks complete 3 months of dedicated practice, accumulating abundant merits. Offer your most sincere devotion to these monks. Their combined merits, combined with your heartfelt prayers, can save your mother from hell and prevent her from becoming a hungry ghost." So, on the 15th day of the 7th lunar month, Modgalyana offered his deepest devotion to the monks, asking for their blessings to rescue his mother. The monks earnestly prayed, and eventually, the hungry ghosts in hell felt the influx of merits. One by one, they were liberated from their suffering. Modgalyana's story has been passed down through generations, particularly among Buddhists. Thus, every year during the 7th lunar month, which is also known as the month of repaying kindness in Buddhism, followers visit temples to pray for their parents and express gratitude for their nurturing love. All right, the Buddhist legend related to the Zhongyuan festival ends here. However, in folk beliefs, many people consider that on this day, the gates of the underworld are open, allowing ghosts to return home to receive offerings or visit their living relatives. Yet, during this period, there are also malicious ghosts that emerge to harm humans. Therefore, on this day, various customs and taboos have developed in the folk traditions, and some of them have persisted to this day. First, let's explore some of the customs associated with the Zhongyuan festival. The first one is releasing river lanterns. River lanterns are also known as lotus lanterns. As the name suggests, these lanterns float on the water's surface. On the Zhongyuan festival, especially in the southern regions, people create lanterns that can float on water. These lanterns have a candle placed in a holder at the base, which is lit. In the evening, these river lanterns are set afloat on lakes or rivers, drifting along with the current. This act is intended to offer blessings to water spirits or wandering souls without a home. If you're interested in stories related to water spirits, you can refer to the channel's episode on Wang Lulang. The second one is burning street clothes. On the Zhongyuan festival night, people take out incense and paper-made clothes, money, and other offerings to burn. They pray beside the fire, expressing their grief. People believe that by doing so, their deceased loved ones can receive warm clothes and money in the afterlife, ensuring their comfort in the netherworld. Many individuals choose to conduct these rituals at intersections, believing that this ensures smooth transportation of these offerings, allowing the clothes and money to reach the departed more quickly. The third one is making eggplant pastries. Folk belief holds that eggplant pastries can serve as sustenance for ancestors in the afterlife. Every Zhongyuan festival, particularly in the southern regions, households make eggplant pastries. The process is not complicated. Fresh eggplants are sliced, coated with flour, and then deep-fried in oil. The fourth one is praying for a bountiful harvest. Especially in rural areas, people often insert a stick of incense into an open area at their doorstep, a practice known as butian. This act is seen as a blessing, hoping for a good harvest in the upcoming autumn. The final one is releasing sky lanterns. Sky lanterns, also known as Kongming lanterns, use the principle of differential air pressure inside and outside the lantern to ascend into the sky. People release sky lanterns at the Zhongyuan festival. Firstly, it's a gesture to chase away misfortune and invite good luck. Secondly, it's believed that sky lanterns can guide departed ancestors to find their way to becoming celestial beings in the heavens. So, what are the taboos on the Zhongyuan festival in folk culture? The first taboo is not to hang clothes outside at midnight. People believe that hanging clothes outside on the night of the Zhongyuan festival could attract ghosts. Wet clothes act as traps for capturing ghosts, and ghosts stuck on clothes would naturally be angered. Angry ghosts might seek trouble from the owner of the clothes. The second taboo is not to have disheveled hair. It's believed that wandering spirits and wild ghosts often have disheveled hair. If someone ventures out late at night with their hair unkempt, these spirits might consider it an invitation for a chat with a fellow spirit. The third taboo is to avoid incessantly talking about ghosts. On this day, spirits roam the human realm. If someone keeps discussing ghosts, the spirits might think they are being talked about and might investigate the situation. The fourth taboo is not to tread on objects by the roadside, especially offerings. During this day, various rituals are conducted, and people sometimes leave behind offerings. These offerings are left for ancestors to enjoy, and if someone steps on them, the ancestors receiving the offerings might get angry, punishing those who lack manners. Taboo 5. Avoid taking photos at night. It's advisable not to take photos indiscriminately outside during the evening of the Zhongyuan festival. Otherwise, ghosts might take an interest in being photographed with you. Also, avoid shining flashlights into dark areas or trees to prevent disturbing them. Taboo 6. Avoid patting others on the shoulder. Folk belief suggests that everyone has three inner fires centered on both shoulders and the head, which prevent ghosts from getting too close. Therefore, during the ghost-filled Zhongyuan festival, one should avoid casually patting others on the shoulder. Patting out the fires on someone's shoulder might just attract the attention of ghosts. Taboo 7. Avoid whistling. Whistling is considered frivolous behavior. Naturally, ghosts find such people more approachable. Taboo 8. Avoid standing close to walls. Folk belief suggests that ghosts prefer to cling to walls. When people lean against walls, ghosts might find them more affable than the walls themselves. Taboo 9. Avoid wearing paranormal items. At the Zhongyuan festival, people avoid wearing items like red strings, bells, and wind chimes. It's believed that ghosts are fond of such decorations and might follow anyone wearing them. Taboo 10. Avoid picking up coins from the street. Don't randomly pick up coins from the roadside, as these coins might be misfortune tokens discarded by others, or they might be intended as tolls for ghosts. Taboo 11. Avoid placing chopsticks in the center of a meal. While eating, don't stick two chopsticks into the center of the meal, as it resembles an incense offering in a censer. Ghosts might mistake it for an offering of food. If you eat the food afterward, they might get angry. Taboo 12. Avoid opening umbrellas indoors. Umbrellas are believed to store ghosts. Opening an umbrella indoors on the 15th day of the lunar 7th month might let ghosts escape from it. Taboo 13. Avoid swimming in rivers. On this day, avoid swimming in rivers or streams on the outskirts. Water spirits might grab your feet, seeking to replace their position in the water forever. Of course, whether customs or taboos, they all stem from people's associations with the unknown and their reverence for life. Here, I'd like to emphasize that the legends, customs, and taboos related to the Zhongyuan festival are all ancient Chinese traditions passed down to express emotions. There is no negative intention, and I encourage everyone to listen with reason. The story, folk customs, and taboos related to the Zhongyuan festival have been covered here. If you enjoy our channel, please like and subscribe. If you have preferences for specific types of stories, feel free to leave a comment in the section below and let us know. Once again, thank you for your support and appreciation. Until next time,
goodbye
to our dear friends.